why I'm glad the space shuttle blew up. No! It wasn't the classroom full of school kids on TV, all whimpering in horror of what they'd seen on the screen. Each one of them still wearing one of those pointed birthday hats. No! Our first reaction at my house was each of us daring the other to call up the local San Francisco papers and say, oh, hi there. We're that legendary Libyan hit squad you've written so much about. And we blew up the space shuttle. Late that night, we gave up the idea. Same old excuse. What if we get caught? Sometimes, you know, it really does make sense just to chicken out. But now I find out we were pretty damn lucky. If the Challenger had made it home, things might now be much worse. Because NASA had this little plan for the following space shuttle they somehow forgot to tell us about. Got in the mail Xerox of a magazine called The Nation, and this later turned up in Common Cause, where they reported NASA had these plans to send the next scheduled shuttle into orbit carrying a payload of 46 pounds of plutonium. It only took a few specs to give Karen Silkwood those zits. 46 pounds of plutonium. If that one had blown up, there'd be enough radiation in the air to cause cancer in as many as 5 billion people. How reckless can you get? Up, up, and away! We'll just launch Star Wars the easy way. Fire it up into the great beyond and just don't tell anybody you put it there. After all, in America, when people don't know what hurts them, they don't care. Just blame the mysterious fallout cancer epidemic on Gaddafi. And think of all the money people we know and love would make selling how to cope with cancer kits to Rolling Stone readers and yuppies. That's why I'm glad the space shuttle blew up. Because if that next one had gone up, it might have blown up and melted all of us, too.